If somebody comes with you with a million pictures of dogs and cats, and you have two models, one that's going to get 90% of them correctly and one 70%. So the one that gets only 70%, a human will still have to look at 300,000. So you made a dent on the problem, but tying, like baking the model into your process is expensive. So unless the ROI is huge, it sometimes is not even worth to use AI. You know what? If I'm going to use 300, look at 300,000, instead of like taking the dependency on this mysterious black box, I'll just going to do all the whole million. But now do a 90% of them correctly. And now the human has to only do 100,000. This is an order of magnitude improvement from a million to 100,000. It starts like clicking and, oh, there's something here. It's probably worth me taking the time to integrate AI into my process and to reap these benefits. This is the practical consideration. There's also the psychological consideration. We just found in practice, if a user is looking at a model and it's getting four answers wrong out of, or three out of every 10, they quickly lose trust. And they start like having doubts. Oh, so it got four wrong. Do I really trust it with the other six or seven? Should I now go and check everything? Like, I'm actually not sure I want to use this AI thing. I don't really trust it. But if you like have one wrong in every 10, users are like starting to, oh, this is like magic, really. It's great. It got this one wrong. But also when this happens, it's usually the one that your model got wrong is wrong for a reason. It's usually very hard. So the user will justify it. They're going to look at it. Oh, I can see why the model got it wrong. There's like weird handwriting. There's like a full scan. There's like a coffee stain on the picture. I feel you, model. Okay, it's fine. Let's move on. So this psychological factor can be very impactful in whether the user will adopt your model or not.